Our topic is binomial theorem of probability.
What is binomial's theorem of probability?
Let's see. Let's say we have an event E. Okay. P is the probability of occurrence of E in a trial. What is the meaning of what I am saying? Let's say we toss a coin. Getting a head, if that is the event, then P is the probability of occurrence of head in a one trial, that is tossing a coin. Or we throw a die and we want 6. So if 6 is the event, then P is the probability of getting a 6 in one throw of a die. Clear? Then let's say Q is the probability of non-occurrence of E in the trial. That is, if E was getting head, then Q is not getting head in the trial, that is getting tail. Or if 6 was what we wanted in a random experiment of throwing a die, then Q is not getting a 6. So this is P, this is Q. These are probabilities. So if the trial is repeated n number of times, then the probability of getting event E exactly r number of times. First of all, what will be? We'll have NCR. That is, in one trial, I told you tossing a coin, this is the probability of getting head is P, that is 1 by 2 half. This was 2, this was 1. So, getting a probability of P is NCR. This is how we get R number of times the required event P when N number of trials has been done. So this is NCR, and we want to have every time we want to get P, that is P multiplied for R times, and not getting Q, that is Q multiplied N minus R times. This will be the probability of event E occurring exactly R number of times when the total number of trials is N, that is NCR into PPPPPR times into QQQQ N minus R. Clear? This is getting R out of N. This is P R times and N minus R times we have Q. So this is what we will get. This will get NCR PR times, that is P to the power R, and QN minus R times, so Q to the power N minus R. PR given by this is called binomial theorem of probability, that the probability of getting an event R number of times out of N number of trials is equal to NCR into P to the power R into Q to the power N minus R, where P is the probability of occurrence of E in a single trial and Q is the probability of occurrence of E, non-occurrence of E in one trial. And obviously P plus Q is 1. So this is binomial theorem of probability. We'll see examples to understand this. Our first problem is, if a die is thrown 5 times, what is the probability that an even number will come exactly 3 times? So how many times the die is thrown? 5 times. And exactly 3 number of times we want that particular probability.
and that particular probability corresponds to the event that an even number comes.
So when you throw a die, what is the probability that what is the probability of getting an even number? This you know, the sample space is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and even numbers are 2, 4, 6. So therefore this is 3, this is 6. Probability will be 3 by 6, that is 1 by 2. Therefore, probability of non-occurrence of this event is 1 minus 1 by 2, that is half. So by binomial theorem, what we get? The desired probability, we write it like this. 3, because R is 3. So the desired probability is, what was the formula? NCR P to the power R Q to the power N minus R. So this will be 5C3 P is half to the power 3 into Q. Q is again half N minus R. That is 5 minus 3. That is 2. So this is our probability. This will be factorial 5 by factorial 3, factorial 2. This will be 1 by 2, 2, 2, and then this is 1 by 2, 2. What we get? We get factorial 5 is 5 cross 4. If we take 5 cross 4, we get factorial 3. Factorial 3, factorial 3 cancels, and this is a 2. This is 2 to the power 5, that is 4, 16, 32, 64. And again this thing, so 128, 16. This is the probability. Our second example is, it says if two dice are thrown 5 times, we have 2 dice and we throw it 5 times. Then the sum of the numbers coming in one trial, let that event be 10. Sum of numbers coming in one trial is 10. So it says if the two dice are thrown 5 times, what is the probability that a sum of 10 will come exactly 2 times? Clear? So we have n equal to 5. We have 5 trials and r is 2. The question is exactly 2 times. Now what is the probability of getting 10 when we are throwing 2 dice? See, when we throw a dice, the sample space will be 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, then 2, 1, 2, 2. So there will be 6 into 6, 36 elements in the sample space. And the set of those pairs with the sum of which is 10 will be, when we have 1, 2, 3, you add 6, it doesn't come to 10. When you have 4 on the first die and 6 on the second die, this is 10, or 5 on both, or 6 on the first and 4 on the second. So these are the 3 possibilities where the sum is 10. So NA is equal to 3. Therefore, probability is 3 by 36, that is 1 by 12. When P is 1 by 12, Q is 1 minus 1 by 12, that is 11 by 12. Therefore, now we can have the probability of getting a sum of 10 exactly 2 times when the number of trials is 5. What will that probability be? 5C2 cross P, that is 1 by 12 into R, that is 2, and then 1 by 12 into, not 1 by 12, 11 by 12 to the power 5 minus 2, 3. This is our probability, the required probability. What will this be? This will be factorial 5 by factorial 3, factorial 2. Cross 1 by 12 into 12, cross 11 into 11 into 11,
by 12 into 12 into 12. So if you calculate this, the answer will be, so if you calculate this, this will come to this 6655 by 124416. This is the required probability.
Our next question is, it says if a coin is tossed 10 times or we throw 10 coins, it's the same. If you throw 10 coins and you count how many heads you have got or how many tails you have got, or you toss the coin 10 times, it's the same. So if we have 10 coins, either we throw at once or we toss the coin 10 times, this is the question. Then it says, what is the probability of getting at least 5 heads, exactly 5 heads? So
N is 10, R is 5. What is the probability of getting head? When you toss a coin, the probability of getting a head is half. Therefore, Q is also half. The answer is, therefore, the probability of getting 5 heads is 10C5 cross half by half to the power R, that is 5 into half to the power 10 minus 5, N minus R, that is 5. This is what we get. So how to solve this? This is factorial 10 by factorial 5, again factorial 5, into 1 to the power 2 to the power 5. 2 to the power 5 is 32. So 32 into 32. So you have to calculate it. The value will be 63 by 256. This is what we will get. Okay. The second part of this question is the same question. What is the probability of getting a head at least 8 number of times? It says at least 8 number of times. What is the meaning of this? At least 8 number of times means we have to find P at 8 plus P at 9 plus P at 10. What will get? P at 8 will be 10C8 1 by 2 to the power 8 into 1 by 2 to the power 2 plus 10C9 1 by 2 to the power 9 into 1 by 2 to the power 1 plus 10C10, that is all our heads, 1 by 2 to the power 10, and this will be 1 by 2 to the power 0, that is 1. So what we say is 1 by 2 to the power 10 into these things. So you work this out, the answer will be 7 by 128. This is the probability of getting at least 8 number of times the event that we want. And what is the event? Of getting head. Okay, this is the question. Now let's see the next question. The next question is, it says if a coin is tossed n number of times, what is the probability that a head will appear an odd number of times? Question is, a coin is tossed n number of times, what is the probability that a head will appear an odd number of times? What we actually mean is, we want to find the probability at 1 plus 3, 5, odd number of times, till the nth time, if we are tossing it for n times. So if n is odd, then pn, if n is even, then pn minus 1. So we actually want to know this. What we will get? Probability will be n c1 p1, n number of times 1, into probability of getting head is half to the power r 1, into q is also half of not getting head, to the power n minus 1. Clear? N minus 1, n minus r, q to the power r. Then NC2 1 by 2 to the power 2 into 1 by 2 n minus 2 and so on. Sorry, not 2, 3. 3.
n minus 3, because we have to find out
the odd values only. So this will be for 3, then 5, then 7, and so on.
What we essentially get is 1 by 2 n minus 1, and this is, so this is 1 by 2 to the power n. Again here, 3 n minus 3, so this is 1 by 2 to the power n. So what we get, we can take 1 by 2 to the power n out of this, and this is nc1 plus nc3 plus nc5, so on, up to n number of times. The value, this is a series, the value of this is 1 by 2 to the power n out, this we get as 2 to the power n minus 1, this is the expansion of it. If we expand this, this will be like this. Now what is this? This is 2 to the power n, this is 2 to the power n minus 1, so the answer is half. Okay, our next question is, we have a factory manufacturing bulbs. It is known that the probability of getting a defective bulb is 0.1. That is, if 100 bulbs are produced, 10 bulbs are found to be defective. So we have P equal to 0.1. Therefore, Q will be 0.9. The question is, if 8 bulbs are taken out from the lot at random, what is the probability that 3 bulbs are defective and 5 bulbs are non-defective? That is, our n is 8. We take out 8 bulbs, and what we want is, the event is of getting 3 defective bulbs and 5 non-defective bulbs. So what it will be? The probability will be very simple. It is 8 out of 8C3. Probability is 0.1, that is 1 by 10 to the power 3 into 9 by 10 to the power 5. 8 minus 3 is 5. So what is this? Factorial 8, factorial 3, factorial 5. This is 9 to the power 5 by 10 to the power 8. So if you calculate this out, this is equal to 0.33.